Alone on a Dark Highway. Today's verse is taken from Deuteronomy 31, verse 6. Be strong and have strength of heart. Do not be afraid or shake with fear because of them. For the Lord your God is the one who goes with you. He will be faithful to you. He will not leave you alone. I had been driving for only about 2 months, Greg told me, and I wasn't familiar with freeway driving at night. I was cruising around 60 to 70 miles per hour when from out of nowhere I saw a full-grown elk with antlers standing in my lane. There was no time to even think. As my windshield shattered, glass and dust flew into my mouth as I gasped for air. The next thing I remember was realizing that my car was off the road on its side, with the driver's side window facing the ground. I tried to crawl out, but my seatbelt stopped me. I managed to unbuckle myself and crawl through another window onto the ground. In shock, I cried out loud to God. I walked onto the road where shattered glass was spread everywhere. I realized that I needed to get help, so I went back to my car to find my cell phone. It was nowhere, so I went back to the road. I found myself helpless, stranded, and alone in the darkness, out in the middle of nowhere. I was powerless. I looked at my SUV lying off the road. It was totaled. Finally, in the far distance, I saw headlights coming toward me. Earlier in the trip, I had removed my shoes because they were uncomfortable, but I started running barefoot toward the oncoming car, jumping and frantically waving my arms. That's when I saw the elk, lying dead on the opposite side of the road. At first, the car passed me, but then the driver realized what had happened and stopped. I ran to the car, and the driver called 911, then checked my injuries. It was a miracle that only my wrist felt sore and my arm was scraped up and bleeding. A few months after the accident, I asked Greg if he had learned a lesson from that night. He told me, "After the accident, when I was standing there in the road, I was completely alone. There were no signs of people, cars, houses, or stores for as far as I could see. I felt completely and utterly helpless. When I felt that feeling of aloneness, I called out to God. I called out to Him because there was no one else. My accident made me realize that I am never alone, despite helpless feelings. God is there, always there, whether I can see Him or not."